Hello everyone, it's Dmitry Anoshin and Surfalytics, and today we'll have really cool overview. It's not the country overview, it's not like cider testings or new lessons for our course. It's actually overview of just recently published OpenAI data roles. And today we'll look what kind of tools using by OpenAI. And honestly, for me, it's a bit surprised that OpenAI hiring traditional data analytics roles like analytics engineer or data engineers. But for us, it's clear sign that we're not yet going to be replaced by AI. And maybe that's the purpose. They want to hire the good people to learn how to replace them. We don't know. But anyway, yeah, I'm just kidding. Let's look. So there are two jobs, and I want to quickly review both of them. And then it gives you idea what kind of skill set you might need for the company like OpenAI. And by the way, they probably have like top tier compensations. I don't know the difference between, for example, software engineering, research scientist, machine learning engineer, and data analytics and engineer, but it will be very interesting to see at least what kind of skills you need and what you need to do. So let's look into it. So the first position is analytics engineer. The team is applied engineering. It's San Francisco, California. You can apply right now. So a couple words about the team. It cross-domain team, research, engineering, product, design, bringing OpenAI technology to consumers. We seek, learn, deployment, distribute benefits of AI. Yeah, it's all clear about the role. The second data engineer, right? It's interesting. It's analytics data engineer. And it's like either analytics engineer or data engineer or both. And maybe it's the clearest sign that they're all like more traditional for data engineering. And what we have here, so data engineer, take the lead build our data pipelines and core tables for OpenAI. Those pipeline crucial for powering analysis safety systems that guide business decision, product growth. So it's kind of like traditional job description for product focused company. And for example, in the past, I read how OpenAI work, how the software engineers can interact with the product managers, how fast they can ship the features and everything. And I know how those things works. For example, when I used to work in Amazon in Cambridge, I did the same. I work with the product team. We collect the data, and our goal was to establish the quality of Amazon Alexa and how it works, how the customers interact, they release new features and measure them. So it's really cool that they're doing this. And I was thinking they're using some like rocket science to do this, but looks like they just do the traditional things. Yeah, the value, data-driven insights, your contributions, OpenAI, and blah, blah, blah. Design, build, manage data pipelines, of course. Data warehouse, yeah, you see, like even OpenAI is using data warehouse, so it's good sign. Develop kind of data sets, product key metrics, user growth. So really, like as I usually tell everyone, you need to really focus on the product part of the business. So because the things that you do with data, you do it for the business, you do it for the product, you do it for the customers. That's why I often mention like analytics value chain, that like you work with the data, help to make decisions, but you drive the value for the different stakeholders like customers, employees, and shareholders. Participate data architecture, engineering decisions, bring your strong experience, knowledge to bear. So now let's see what they have. Just 3 years of experience as a data engineer, 8 years of software engineering experience. So their goal, for data engineering role, they look at someone really hands-on experience, writing lots of code, because I bet they're the data volume is huge. So they Python, Scala, Java, and but I think it's still a big difference. Like data engineering with Python and Scala, especially with the Python, might be quite different skill set from the Scala and Java. But some data engineers, they know everything equally well, especially if they have a software engineering background. So distributed processing technology and framework, so this is clear. But in this case, they mentioned Hadoop. Is there an HDFS and S3? So I don't think they're using something on-premise with HDFS. It's probably something in the cloud. They didn't mention what kind of public cloud they use, because on one hand, they have partnership with Microsoft Azure, and they might use HD Insight, for example. On other hand, they mention S3, and maybe their every team can do whatever they want. So they can drive their hardware things and their core GPT logic in Azure data centers, but for analytics, they decide to use S3. They can use Elastic MapReduce for HD Insight. They use some streaming capabilities with Flink. By the way, Hadoop, Flink, and HDFS S3 is not the data warehouse, it's data lake. Maybe they have something on top. I don't know. They can have like Lakehouse, they can use Redshift or Snowflake, whatever. They can do anything. So expertise with ETL schedulers like open source Airflow, Dux, or Prefect. Those basically the three most popular one. Definitely Airflow like leading here. Prefect, another one I used to work, and Duxter. They equally okay and good for the work. And for work with them, Python is enough. Solid understanding of Spark. So I think all the core logic is transformed with the Spark. Of course you need to write, optimize Spark code and do many things. The salary, salary, as you can see, on one hand, like 250k, even it's not the senior role, right? It's good salary for California. And I don't know, is it like base salary or like some bonus? And it's not public company, even as you know, Elon Musk trying to sue this company and make it non-profit. So I don't know, like maybe it's the base salary, like 400 base US, it's pretty decent salary, but with cost of living in San Francisco, it's probably not rocket science. So for typical software engineer, like the good software engineer usually can get like beyond 500. And with the recent, like how the tech stocks growing, for example, Apple, Facebook, Meta, like they probably like they beyond those numbers. Another role is analytics engineer. So it's not the data engineer, it's analytics engineer. Usually for me, analytics engineer means someone who using DBT, lots of SQL, and really dive deep into business transformation in the logic. But here we can see what they have here. Strong proficiency with SQL, comfort at least one functional language, and basically you should know like the Python, obviously. And everyone in analytics engineer know the Python. By the way, here I didn't see any reference to like my favorite topic, engineering excellence. Like what's about CI/CD pipeline? What's about data quality and some other things? And but it's probably a really valuable thing, and maybe because the job is tied to the software engineering background, it's just by default. But you know, it's the first position that we see that OpenAI related to traditional data. In the past, I was waiting then, for example, SpaceX will do something in the space, or maybe Blue Origin from Jeff Bezos, because, for example, I have background in similar industry. I used to work 3 years in space manufacture, and that's why I was like, oh, it would be great to do the analytics related to like those space companies. But here we see nice things. In the role, about the role, about the team, finance team sits finance org. So probably you need to really care about the metrics. They have some financial reporting. Very often the company have ARR metrics. So probably for SaaS companies, active annual revenue, no, annual recurring revenue, RR. Yeah, so this metric is the most important, and you need based on the subscription. So for example, I pay subscription to OpenAI, they multiply it by 12. This is an annual recurring revenue. They can do it monthly and so on and so on. The team subject metrics are financial transactions data. So they probably pick up the data from backend systems. And I'm curious what kind of backend systems they have. They not really give details here. And they maybe they work close with another kind of data engineering team who brings all the data for them and extract from source systems. As an analytics engineer, you can early member finance data team building foundational scale analytics across business functions and impact. Oh, sorry, I didn't want to zoom it. Finance and the business team understand their pain points to take lead on proposing valuable future-proof solutions. Yeah, of course, like all kinds of things with data and make this awesome solution. So in this role, you will understand data needs. Of course, you need to understand the data needs and like work, collaborate with different parties, support the development of data products and tools to build some kind of self-service analytics, scale across company, lead dimensional design. Oh, that's nice. Because everyone now is obsessed and it's not just the word, but it's actually what I'm looking when I work with this, like the metrics layer, because usually the company has lots of different metrics, how you can organize those metrics, how you can report, make sure that they accurate, the users know them, the logic defined just one time, you have the documentations, business catalog, as soon as you do any change to the core logic, those metrics reflect this logic and every users know this. So it's a bunch of things and there are different ways how you can build this metrics layer. Built inside reliable dashboards, of course, dashboards. I'm just curious what they're using, like Power BI, because they partner Microsoft, or they like Tableau, Looker. And I think that this kind of company, they can do anything in terms of the data and tooling. And you basically, in other words, after some time, we can find that OpenAI is like zoo of tooling, BI tools, every teams can spin up their tool and start using this and this will be completely mess. But who knows? You might thrive this role. 5 years experience analytics engineer, similar role, data analyst, data engineer, canonical data set. So you need to know what's canonical data set, but I think it's related to the quality and you can make sure that the quality is here, it drives some actions and everyone understand what's it. Proficient SQL, of course, the SQL, familiar distributed data sets, S3, Trino, Hive, Spark. So for example, Trino is just your SQL engine on top of S3, and you can use the Iceberg format, or you can just use Parquet. And by the way, if you know Amazon Athena, it's actually Presto open source that was renamed to the Trino. So the Hive, it's really old, like SQL interface for Hadoop, and often it serves as a metadata store for Trino. Spark, you should know what is Spark, and you can do PySpark, Scala, or Spark SQL, doesn't matter if data engineers will define. So, and for orchestration tools, they use Airflow Daxer, obviously perfect. So here, at least here, they specify that they're using GitHub and Stash as the version control. Yeah, engineering excellence, always. Expert creating, compiling data visualization tool. Oh, Tableau and Looker. So it's not the Power BI. I'm happy for OpenAI that they're using something Tableau Looker. So I think if you will compare Tableau and Looker, for analytics engineer, Looker is the better because you have your code, like SQL code, you have version control, you can do the code reviews. The same you can do in the Looker. And excellent community. Of course, the communication skills, your soft skills, the opportunity, how you're going to present the data, and many, many other things. Comfortable with solving ambiguous problem statements in early stage environment, of course. Go-to-market teams, that's very popular. So maybe it's for enterprise, the teams who like going to sell to enterprise company. They know their metrics, they know the usage of OpenAI products, and they want to understand and to upsell, cross-sell. So because part of this job it's really competitive for you, not just doing the poor only data analytics, and then the next benefits is understand how to do this continuous integration, continuous deployment. Then you need really good communicate, collaborate, and be able to write your ideas. And also, if you do the deep dive in the data, you can provide recommendations. Yeah, all those things. So you can listen to me and just apply for the job, be ready like to go through the interview and talk about the things that I just mentioned. Because OpenAI is just another company, and they focus on the quality, they focus on how they can get use of the data. They expect that the person will add the value, will drive some change, and overall improve the situation. So for engineering roles in data, especially if you have opportunity to improve any kind of part of the code, you should always do this. Comfortable, and we've solved, okay, we check these, strategic finance, revenue operations, yeah, experience writing in Scala, and maybe it means just one thing, that for their Spark implementations on top of Elastic MapReduce or Hadoop, whatever they have, they prefer Scala over PySpark, but it doesn't really matter. So if the data there, you can use the notebooks, maybe Jupyter notebooks, maybe it's the jobs, and you can go and build this. And there is also, just recently read about cost reduction using, for example, not Elastic MapReduce, but Elastic MapReduce serverless. That's another way to cost. But I don't think that they now care about the cost. And you can see how the salary difference is really like almost double, right? It was almost 400 for data engineer, right? It's starting 250 to 400, and here it's like 200 to 265. And that's the sign for you that it's good to start from data analyst, BI engineer, then moving to analytics engineer. But eventually you should go to the data engineer if you want to get higher pay band. But on the other hand, in Canada, then we in Surfalytics analyze the jobs and their requirements and what they pay. We often find that analytics engineering and data engineering is paying equally. So if you have more questions or you want to look to other company and see what they have and how they work, send me the link and we can do it. Thank you.